Will Smith has apologized. I guess you can call this an apology. Now, you do have to note here, this apology has come only after Chris Rock decided to start talking publicly about Will Smith. So let me bring you snippets of this apology. Here's the first video.
Why didn't you apologize to Chris in your acceptance speech? I was fogged out by that point. It's all fuzzy. I've reached out to Chris, and the message that came back is that he's not ready to talk, and when he is, he will reach out. So I will say to you, Chris, I apologize to you. My behavior was unacceptable, and I'm here whenever you're ready to talk.
Okay, that was the first part. Will Smith also apologized to the family of Chris Rock. Here it is.
I want to apologize to Chris's mother. I saw an interview that Chris's mother did, and you know, that was one of the things about that moment. I just didn't realize, and you know, I wasn't thinking, but how many people got hurt in that moment. So I want to apologize to Chris's mother. I want to apologize to Chris's family, specifically Tony Rock. You know, we had a great relationship. You know, Tony Rock was my man. This is probably irreparable. But I can say to all of you, there is no part of me that thinks that was the right way to behave in that moment. There's no part of me that thinks that's the optimal way to handle a feeling of disrespect or insults.
Okay, it doesn't stop there. He also addressed the question about if Jada made him do it. Here it is.
After Jada rolled her eyes, did she tell you to do something? No. It's like, you know, I made a choice on my own from my own experiences, from my history with Chris. Jada had nothing to do with it. I'm sorry, babe. I'm gonna say sorry to my kids and my family for the heat that I brought on all of us.
I told you from day one why Will Smith did this, and it was not in protection of Jada. And Will Smith actually revealed the reason why he did this deed. Here it is.
Disappointing people is my central trauma. I hate when I let people down. So it hurts. It hurts me psychologically and emotionally to know I didn't live up to people's image and impression of me. And the work I'm trying to do is I am deeply remorseful, and I'm trying to be remorseful without being ashamed of myself. Right, I'm human, and I made a mistake, and I'm trying not to think of myself as a piece of.
Interesting. Now, I said when this first happened, Will Smith slapping Chris Rock was not about protecting his wife Jada. It was about Will Smith. That's my opinion, and I stand by it. And I think there are a few people that Will Smith would have never got out of his seat and slapped. I don't think he ever would have slapped Steve Harvey. I don't think he would have slapped Will Ferrell. Hell, he wouldn't have slapped Ben. Okay? There are plenty of folks he would not have slapped. And beyond the moment, which I felt so bad for Chris Rock in that moment. But in that moment, the aftermath of Will Smith being able to sit back down and laugh and enjoy the festivities after he's done something like this to another black male. And let me say this about Hollywood's fascination with status, and by extension, our fascination with status. If this was anyone other than Will Smith, we would have a very different take on it. Let's say Donald Trump did something like this. Would we be providing contextualization to the action? Of course not. What if Will Smith would have slapped, let's say, Tom Cruise? You think they would have let Will Smith sit on that front seat for the rest of the show? Okay. All right, Ben, thoughts here?
I agree with what you said, except for I think he would have probably slapped me.
Ben, I think he would have had his hands full if he did, Ben. That's what true. I think.
That is a fact. I think overall that was a pretty solid apology. He apologized to everybody, Chris and his mother, quite literally. I think he's still apologizing right now to Chris's baker. He's sorry that Chris wasn't able to get his bread the next morning. It was a little too hard for him to chew into it with a sore jaw. He apologized to Tony Rock, who's a friend of mine. Tony and I have been friends for decades now, almost two decades. And Will Smith gave Tony his first break. He put him on a show that he and Jada produced called All of Us on UPN, yep, the old UPN network. And I was at the rap party for season one. Tony invited me to, and Will was there and came up on stage and gave some speech thanking everybody, and then took off his shirt and he had a black undershirt on, and they put a gold chain on him, and DJ Jazzy Jeff came out and they played all their hits. It was exciting. They were close. It was one of the coolest moments of my life. Then Biz Markie came out and DJed the party. It was insane. And they were close, and he helped make his career. I don't think there's any personal vendetta where Will Smith wanted to take down Chris Rock. I think he flipped out. I do think must have been Jada said something. I think he probably did do it for his own, because of his own demons, but he laughed at the joke. Yeah, and then exactly. Jada, right. And then all of a sudden Jada's upset and he went up and did it. Maybe Jada didn't say do anything, but he saw his wife being upset. But you just can't do it. As I predicted right when it happened, look what's gonna happen to comics now. And it's happening. Look at Chappelle getting attacked on stage. Look at somebody bringing a gun into my friend Craig Robinson's show in North Carolina the other day, and the whole club having to be evacuated. Or my friend Brad Williams on stage, they had to clear out when people ran in. There was a mistaken thought of an active shooter the other day in a Vegas hotel. This is, you cannot take physical action because of a slight, because of an insult, let alone one done by an artist in a joking way, let alone one done in the mildest way possible. It's the Oscars, they're in the front row, every big celebrity gets made fun of, and the big insult that made him go and strike Chris Rock was that he said her short hair looked like G.I. Jane's short hair. G.I. Jane's one of the most badass female characters in film history. He was saying you look like a badass character. Not really a reason to go and slap somebody in the face. So I'm glad that Will Smith does seem contrite and seems to be apologizing. I just got word he's finishing his apology right now. He just finished listing them out.
Well, listen, it has not hurt Will Smith. He has already banked the largest upfront paycheck of anybody in Hollywood this year. So it has not hurt his pockets. Chris Rock has said he's going to talk more about the Will Smith situation at his Netflix special.